Matty Smith puts the kick in goal. There's a chase on. Well, there's a chase on and a dive by Bowen and O'Loughlin. Try is given. It is confirmed. Wigan have the opening score here. Williams to Smith. Smith across to Bowen again, who's involved in that line. And here's Gelling. Right, and Gelling reaches through. Eventually does find a way through on that right-hand side. Rangiche comes out, but the ball is slipped away by Bowen. It's out eventually to Charlie, who's aimed back towards the middle. And Josh Charlie makes a try out of relatively little. And Wigan have scored two tries back-to-back. Salford fresh in terms of it's early in this second half, but they've got some really hard work to do here. Gelling now with an arcing run to the right-hand side and tries to bully his way over, and he will claim that he's put that ball down. Try is confirmed. Rangiche, a little kick back towards his left-hand side. Josh Griffin knew what was coming, and I think he might have scored here.
I think he's got that down.
The ball was bouncing awkwardly, and the try is confirmed. Matty Smith back inside to Matty Bowen, who flies through the gap and passes away. And it's going to be a hat-trick try for Anthony Gelling, who touches down with relish. Oh, here come Wigan again, sauntering through the middle. Magical stuff from George Williams. Absolutely bewitched and bemused as Salford defence. He did not look like a try scorer until that final moment when he simply ghosted past Evels. The fullback beat all ends up, and Wigan have another try. Oh, Salford have knocked on again, and the ball is kicked downfield by Tony Club. And Club's after this, and Club will touch down and celebrate the unlikeliest of tries. Salford with the ball in their hands, they knocked on, it was had downfield by Tony Club, and the big prop forward was the first man up there to chase it. The boy from Gravesend, boy, how well has he done? Matty Smith caps an outstanding performance by unpicking that Salford defence, and the try is confirmed. Matty Smith is given the score that he deserves.
You know, I think we needed that performance. You know, come off the back of last week, we really disappointed last week, and you know, it gives us a chance at League Leaders Shield again now. We currently sit 2 points behind again, and you know, we need Saints to slip up, but I think putting in performances like that back into the year is going to set us in good stead for the playoffs.
Yeah, I think we're done deep. We spoke about a lot of stuff through week after last week, and I think put it into practice, and I think we're spot on today. I think it's one of the best games we've played this year, honestly. I think showing Salford they've been playing well, I think we turned them over well, so I think we did well all then.
Did you expect to put them away quite so comprehensively?
No, to be honest with you, we knew that they'd be playing well, and we knew we'd have to dig deep if we wanted to put some points, and I think that's what we did. I think just the great and hard work that we did, I think it just paid off in the end.
Yeah, we talked about it at half-time. I mean, we had a great first 40 minutes, but, you know, we needed to come out that second half and really, you know, prove a point that we're an 80-minute side, and coming to the back end of the year now, especially in these playoffs, you need to play for 80 minutes, and I thought we did that brilliantly tonight, and, you know, we need to keep that going now for the rest of the year.
Yeah, it was awesome. Boys really fronted up this week after a poor showing against Bradford, really. So I thought the first 40 minutes was a real tough affair, and then the second half I think we pulled away a bit with our structures, and I think that first 40 minutes to an hour just ground them down a little bit, so it was a really good win for the boys.
Shaun, that was pretty ruthless as a performance goes.
Yeah, it would have been nice to nil them. It was a soft try what they scored, but yeah, ruthless the way they responded. It's been a tough week for the players. When you consider the age of our squad and the players out, and we can put 41 points on a team what's been handpicked from around the world. You know, they spend a lot of money on their team, and they've been handpicked as what they've identified as possibly the best players in the world. So for us to put that performance on that, you know, with some of our kids playing was great. You know, we've got players coming back, so we're in good shape.
What we did today, we allowed Wigan to play on their terms. We allowed them to do what they wanted to do with the ball. We didn't do the small things that we've been doing consistently as a defensive team for periods. And you know, when you do that and they've got the skill that they've got as a team, then you know, you're going to concede points, and you know, they just grew in confidence, and we dropped our heads. So you know, it's a big lesson for us.